You've been staying with us. Hollywood producer Byron Allen is our guest. And again, the number to call to speak to Byron is 800-450-7876. Just want to remind you, in the next few days, Dr. Arthur Lewin, a professor in New York City, is going to join us. He's going to want us to talk about Cleveland, that issue with the police and how and the police, this consent decree. Also, a mystery man, Mark from Anaheim, is going to be here. And also, Kabe Kabene. Some of you know him as Booker T. Coleman, Dr. Booker T. Coleman from the Hidden Colors series. He's going to be here as well. Before we left, I was asking Byron. Byron, because the president says that he tries to get a lot of stuff done, but he can't because of Congress. And he also pointed out that the immigration thing is sort of stalled and maybe tossed out totally because of Congress. Your response when he says that Congress is blocking what he's trying to implement?
That's not true. He can. There are things that he can definitely do, and that's not the hope and change that he promised us, and he can deliver on that. You know, you already have the laws in place, President Obama, to go to the banks and audit the banks and say, look, you're not. There's no fair lending here. You're not lending to black people. He has spent $700 billion bailing out banks. There are banks out there that do not have one commercial loan to one black person in this country. He can fix that immediately and say to them, you've got to start lending money to black people so we can buy homes and finance our businesses. You don't need Congress for that. He already has a budget for education. You have to improve it. He has it. He has the ability to take those ad dollars because President Clinton mandated that government advertising go to black newspapers. That was a presidential mandate that, by the way, was ignored. And 10 years later, Senator Kerry did an investigation and found out that that mandate was ignored. Said, why are you ignoring a presidential mandate to spend money with black newspapers? You were supposed to do it. But when it comes to black, America tends to just continue the economic genocide and shut us out. And he doesn't need Congress to take the trillions of dollars in pension fund money and make sure that it's in the hands of qualified, capable African Americans to manage it and invest it in our communities. Congress is not involved in any of those economic steps or educational steps. He's much brighter than that. He knows it, and I know it. And by the way, if you need me to, I'll go speak to Congress. Listen, brother President Barack Obama, I'm here. I'm here to help. I'm here to support. And if you need me to, I'll deal with Congress. But we're not going to let them continue the economic genocide against our people.
Byron, you spoke about newspapers, and joining us right now on line five is Gene Klingman. He writes a syndicated columnist in all of the black newspapers, not just in this country, but on this planet. It's called Blackonomics. Jim, you're on with Byron.
Good morning, my brothers. Carl, I'm reminded of about a month ago or 2 months ago when I called you to ask you if you could get Mr. Allen on your show. So I will compliment you, first of all, for having him on this morning. Mr. Allen, what you're saying, everything you have already said about economic empowerment or economic inclusion, as you termed it, I've been saying for the last 25 years or so, and you hit on several points that I wanted to have you stretch out on. I just wrote a new book called Black Dollars Matter, Teach Your Dollars How to Make More Sense. And on page 28, there's an article titled Obama Ain't Your Mama. And I think I wrote that back in 2007 or 2008. On page 77, there's a piece called Strategic Alliances, which talks about something you hit on when it comes to economic inclusion. But most importantly, on page 172, there's a piece titled Including Ourselves in Economic Inclusion. And that's where I want us that's where I want to focus, because what you said is true about all the economic issues we face about King and how he was killed and why he was killed and all of that. The one thing that I want to stress is that we must move toward being the includers rather than the includees all the time. which means that we need to build strategic alliances and partnerships among our own businesses to increase the numbers of people that we can hire and do the kinds of things that you laid out in the last half hour to include ourselves in these projects. We have been waiting for others to include us, as you have talked about with the president and others. But while we're waiting, we should be doing a lot of things among ourselves. And with that said, I want you to respond to not only that, but to the issue of support from what you called, affluent Black Americans like yourself. Because I'm involved in a movement, and I know other people who are involved in movements, legal and otherwise, that can really be advantaged by what, not only what you say, but what you can bring to the table on a tangible basis. So I'll stop there. I've been talking too long right now, but I'll stop there and hear your feedback and maybe give you a closing comment, if Carl will allow me.
First of all, sir, thank you for all of your hard work. That is very important work that you do, because we as African Americans, we have got to live by the economics. We've got to stay disciplined about the numbers. It is so, so important. It is important to realize our power. We, as African Americans, spend over $1 trillion a year. It was in the civil rights movement, our two greatest weapons, legal and economic pressure. Thank God for the magnificent African-American generation that stayed off that bus, for those buses, for 387 days, I think is the correct number, a little over a year. And because they missed our money on those buses, after 1 year, they said, you Negroes can sit wherever you want. That was our greatest moment in showing who we were as a people, and you must respect us if you want our money. That's the reason why I sued AT&T, because I really wanted Black America to know that they're not doing business with us, and not only are they not doing business with us, they're calling us niggas, and they're covering it up. You need to understand that lawsuit, those lawsuits, and the economics of that, the billions of dollars that AT&T takes out of our community. And when two very brave African-American executive assistants at AT&T, Nomi King being one of them, brought this to the attention of the board of AT&T and the chairman of AT&T that one of their presidents had called us niggas, both women were escorted out of the building. Okay, but they promoted that executive and paid him more money for close to a year, 2 years, over a year and a half. That's what we have to say to the chairman of AT&T and the chairman and the board of AT&T. Black people have too much respect, and our money will show you that we are not going to spend money with you. We're going to hold you accountable, and we're going to go to our political leaders and hold you accountable. Our dollars must be used to send a message. Our dollars are important. They need our money. I don't care who it is, Coca-Cola, McDonald's. We have a great deal of power. We just don't use it. Now, as it relates to the Black community and Black wealth, newsflash, Black people, we don't have any money. From time to time, we have good cash flow. We don't have great wealth. You don't have situations with Black families with $3 billion cash liquid.
Yeah, hold that thought right there, Byron. Interesting conversation, folks. Byron Allen is our guest, the Hollywood producer. You can reach him, too. Join the conversation. Get in this dialogue. 800-450-7876. We'll take your calls after this traffic report on 1450. WOL, where information is power.